Hey, how's it going, everyone? Welcome to the balcony of the flat that I'm staying in Kuala Lumpur. The sun is just about setting and I'm about to do a time lapse, and I thought I would feature a setup that I've featured on my Instagram stories, and I had such a response from that I thought it was worthwhile sharing in a video because I think it's probably got some value to it. So this is my non-tripod setup. So this is the travel setup that I use for time lapses, long exposures, and I've recently just kind of configured it, and it is this big. So instead of carrying a bulky tripod around, I am carrying just this whilst I'm throughout Singapore and Malaysia the past couple of weeks. And I have to say, it has been a blessing. So I hate carrying a tripod. I do own tripods, I own some very nice ones. I like using them, but I hate carrying them. And this is a Manfrotto friction arm with a super clamp and just a camera mounting plate. And it has honestly just made my back so happy because it fits in my backpack. It's much lighter and it can still hold up to 15 kilos of gear. So I'm gonna run you through the setup for this and then hopefully do a time lapse as well before the sun sets. So if you are interested in this setup, then do check out the links below. I'm gonna link down to my kit.com profile. If you don't follow me on there, then go and check it out. You can see where I post all sorts of gear setups and also just the links to the products as well and some further details just in the description about those. So yeah, let me just set it up and I'll show you how it works. So this is the Manfrotto friction arm. I believe it's the 24 mini, and with it I got the camera plate on here. I actually got this as a set with the larger magic arm, but you can also get these individually. And then I've got a super clamp here, and it's just all connected. So if you've never used one of these, it's very simple. You just have a simple little tightening screw here, undo all of that, and then the three points to this now become loose. Now the design of the super clamp, this third point isn't really active, so that's just kind of like straight in there. So I'm just going to tighten that back up and then undo the super clamp. And this is designed for fairly large areas, so perfectly we've got a railing here. Now it does require having some sort of like, I guess, fixed setup. So this is where a tripod can sometimes be beneficial, but if you do have something like a railing, then this is perfect. So I undo that, I'll fit that into the railing exactly as I want, make it nice and tight. And as I said, this super clamp can have a max load of 15 kilos, so that's a lot of gear. A regular DSLR setup is usually going to push about 2 kilos or so if you've got like a 24-70 2.8 lens. So this will hold a lot of stuff. And then we have the friction arm, and I'm just going to angle it to around about here. Tighten that up nice and tight, and then I'll get a camera to fit in here. So for illustration purposes, I'm going to use my Fuji X-H1. Now doing time lapses, I actually do use the GH5, which this is being filmed on currently. So I just screw that in to the bottom, just like that. And then we can turn this on, unscrew everything, turn on the level on the screen so that you can sort of like align your shot perfectly. And then it's a case of just screwing it into place, tightening it up. And now I have almost a perfect setup for doing long exposures, time lapses. If I need to do any sort of video work, like no hands or anything, I can do this. And not only that, but I can also position it in, kind of weird and wonderful positions because these are super strong. So, I don't know, perhaps you're in an ambiguous place and you want to put it somewhere. Now, if you do also want to get a larger one of these, there are bigger versions available. I just happen to like this because it's nice and small, compact, it's perfect for travel. And it works out really well. Now I've got one further tip that I have been sharing on my Instagram stories that so many people messaged me about, and that is this. This is the lens skirt. Now this is perfect for when you don't have access to a balcony such as this and you're inside and you're shooting through a window. So we actually fix this onto the window. So if we have a look from inside, I can now just clamp this. I'm gonna use the door frame and we just clamp it nice and tight. And of course we're shooting through the window, so the window's gonna have reflections. So if we use this, which is the lens skirt, and we put this into position. Now this has got suctions on here, so we can just stick it physically to the window. And that's gonna block any stray light from getting in, which causes reflections. Nice. Pull the cinch nice and tight. Yeah. And now we can get pretty much reflection-free shots through the window, and yeah. Super useful, and I hope you guys enjoyed that because you've been messaging so much on my Instagram about it. So thanks for watching, catch you in the next one. Bye bye.